Welcome back into Good Day and your legal brief this morning. We're talking about domestic violence. October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month, and nearly 20 people each minute are physically abused by a partner in the United States. That equals to more than 10 million women and men every year. Joining us this morning to let you know what your legal options are is Nicole Sodoma from Sodoma Law. Nicole, thanks for being here. An important topic not only this month, but every month of the year.
What's so striking about, excuse me, the statistic, is that what it's directed at is what you said was physical violence, and the definition of domestic violence may not be just physical violence. It's also it could be the attempt. It could also be the fear of imminent serious harm to you or your family. So understanding the domestic violence definition in our statutes is really important.
And what are the options for people out there who are in these situations?
So the things that you should consider is making a safety plan, and that would be, who am I going to call? Where am I going to go? What am I going to bring with me? Am I going to have an emergency bag? Is it going to have a cell phone charger? Is it going to have an extra set of keys, cash, clothes, important documents?
Because some situations, when you leave, you may not need or want to go back. There's a reason that you're leaving in the first place.
That's right. And if the next step is you actually going and asking the court for a domestic violence order of protection, then you need to be prepared to do all of those things, but also know that the time between the actual event, the occurrence, and asking the court for the order of protection is really important.
And when you say important, does that need to be pretty quickly that needs to happen?
That's exactly right. You should not wait. If there is an act of domestic violence, then it really affects your credibility if you wait too long between the act and actually asking the court for help.
And is this something, at what point do you need to reach out to an attorney?
Well, we have lots of local resources. There's a victims assistance program here in Mecklenburg County. We have legal aid. Asking counsel for help is really important. Looking and understanding what those resources are available to you is really also great. On our website, SodomaLaw.com, we also have a free a booklet, Escaping Domestic Violence, that also is proven to be helpful.
And taking that first step can be the hardest.
It can be the hardest.
And again, that website where people can find you, that information, right, and you.
Right, SodomaLaw.com. Okay. And there's an e-booklet. It's a free resource for you that can help with some
phone numbers, too. People out there probably needing this information. Nicole, thanks so much for coming in today and talking about such an important topic with us. We appreciate it. Stay with us. We've got more Good Day Charlotte on the other side of this break. A beautiful look outside this morning.